So please see this. So this is what we have done. You know, once again, you can see this. I have created a class called customer, a simple class, export customer, which extends from customer, local customer again extends from customer, and the sales app from which in which I've got public static void main, and I have created an object of class customer, and this is the visual representation of what we have done. So here, in case of inheritance, you see export customer extends from, that means it inherits from customer, local customer also inherits from customer. So the point here is that this is the entire concept of generalization and specialization. I repeat, this is the concept of generalization and specialization. So which is the general class here? Out of these three, which one of the three is the general class? Customer is the general class. You will have the general behavior implemented here. General behavior means the behavior which is general between the two, which is common between the two. That kind of behavior will be implemented out here in the customer class. I repeat, your customer class will have the functionality which is exactly similar to both. Like, you know, the way local customer would work on that functionality will be exactly the same how export customer would work. For example, printing the customer details. So suppose if I have a function here in customer class called, you know, I'll say print details. Suppose this is what I have, you know. So I will say public void and print details. So this will print the details of the customer. Customer details are being printed. Okay, like this. So when I do this, customer details are being printed. When I go to my sales app, you will see now I will have customer dot and I will say print details. This is fine, this is okay. But then I can very well say, instead of customer is equal to new customer, see, I am commenting it. I can very well say local customer is equal to new, or rather let me write this as local customer is equal to new local customer. Take a look at this. Did I create an object of customer? No, I created an object of class local customer. But you see, this local customer inherits from customer. So needless to say that here I will have local customer dot, I will get print details for local customer also. Why? You remember I did mention that if my dad has the habit of saving, I will also certainly have that feature of saving. So you see local customer dot print details, and exactly whatever I had written here in the customer class for print details, that will be executed for the local customer. You see this? No worries at all. It will just work like a charm. You see this, customer details are being printed. So local customer, I did not write any function in the local customer, but since it extends from customer and customer has that behavior, local customer will also get that behavior. So very simple. So you see this now, if you know, I have to present that visually, then you see this, I will have a function out here called print details. This is the functionality. So I will certainly have that functionality . You see this? So print details, you know, so certainly in export customer as well as local customer I will get print details. Why? Because both of these inherit from customer. So far so good. So this is the general behavior. This is what I call as general behavior, right? Now you see this, I am creating yet another, right? So customer is a class, print details, but I am creating another function here now. Now this function, I'll say, print invoices or create invoice, right? Create invoice is the functionality, suppose, in the customer class. But there is one very important point here, and the point here is that export customer, the way you create invoice for the export customer, the way you calculate taxes while creating the invoice for the export customer is pretty different as compared to how you calculate taxes and how do you finally build an invoice, create an invoice for the local customer. And for the local customer, you will have GST, you will have, you know, two different GSTs, one for the state, one for the central government, and for the export customer, there will not be any GST at all. And there can be, quite a different way in the way you create invoices for customer, the way you create invoices for the export customer and the local customer. So the logic is different. So now what I'm talking about is the specialized behavior. So this printed details as such was the behavior, but this was general behavior. What I'm talking about now is I'm talking about the specialized behavior. This create invoice has got some special behavior. You got the point? This creating of invoice, how the invoice is created for export customer is different than the way it is created for the local customer. So what I'm going to do here now, I will go ahead with customer class, and here I will just simply declare the availability of that service at the customer level. I'll say public void and I will say create invoice, and please see this, I'm putting a semicolon and I will put an abstract keyword over here. And if I have to, if I create this as an abstract function, what does this mean? It means that you are declaring, once again I repeat, you are declaring a service here, you are declaring a functionality here, but you are not implementing it here. I repeat, you are not implementing it here. You will be implementing in the specialized class out here. So what I'm going to do now is I will make this class also as abstract. I will have to. Why? Because if someone creates an object of this class, and what if that person invokes this function, what will happen? Nothing will happen. I mean, it is the state of ambiguity, isn't it? So your Java compiler in the very first place will not allow you to create a class as non-abstract while having even a single function as abstract. So if you make a function as abstract, you will have to make the class also as abstract. Now, why my IDE is telling me that there is a problem? There are two problems. Why two problems? Because if I have an abstract class and if I have a class extending from the abstract class, I repeat, if I have an abstract class and if I have another class extending from that abstract class, so either I will have to make this class also as abstract, or else I will have to implement the functionality of the abstract functionality here. What is that abstract functionality? I will have to write public void create invoice. Please see this. Now no errors at all. And here I will write, I will write here printing, or rather creating invoice for export customer. You see this? Creating invoice for export customer, and still local customer will have issues. Why? Because in the local customer, I did not implement that functionality. I must implement that functionality here because this class has got, now it says one related problem. Why? Because in the local customer, I did not implement the functionality. This is abstract method. So any class that implements the abstract class must implement all the abstract methods of that class over here. I have just one abstract method. So public void here also, I will say create invoice. You can see that here, and I'll say S out, and I will write here local customer, or what did I write here? Creating invoice, right? So I'll copy paste the same thing, but instead of saying creating invoice for export customer, I'll say creating invoice for the local customer. Here you go. So if I have to represent that visually, then in that case I say I've got create invoice, which is abstract. This is how, usually your abstract is like this, italic in UML, correct? And I will have the implementation of create invoice of create invoice over here. So I'll put this out here, and you will see I will create here create invoice, but you know very well, the create invoice functionality out here, the create invoice functionality out here, okay, this create invoice functionality out here will be very, very specific to the business logic that will be implemented here, will be specific to creating the invoice of export customer. And similarly here, when I implement, I'll say create invoice, this is the functionality, right? And then here I will make this also as 8, okay, oh sorry, okay, 28, correct? This is how it is. So here the functionality that I will implement will be very specific to creating the invoice for local customers. So you see, this is print details is an example of what? Specialization. I repeat, print details is an example of specialization, whereas this is an example of, what is this example of? This is the create invoice is the example of specialization. Print details is an example of generalization. So the general behavior is here, specialized behavior is here. So this is what it is, generalization, specialization. Generalization, the general behavior is there in the superclass, whereas the specialized behavior is there in the subclasses. I repeat, the generalized behavior is there in the superclass, whereas the specialized behavior there is there in the subclasses. As you can see in customer class, this is the generalized behavior, whereas, you know, export customer and local customer has the specialized behavior of creating the invoice. Now when I go to sales app, you see this, I can say local customer. If I say local customer and if I run this, you see this print details is fine. That is the general behavior. But when I say local customer dot and I say create invoice, this will do what? Come on. This will, needless to say, right? This will print the logic of local customer. But if at all I make changes, instead of local customer, if I say export customer, then it will create, while creating the invoice, it will execute the logic of local customer. Now, one final point before we wind up for the day. You know, this is not the way to, you know, do things. So what you will do is, you will say, I'll comment this, I'll still keep this code. You know, the best way to do it is, I'll say customer. So your client class must be dependent on abstraction, not on implementation. So I say customer, customer is equal to new local customer. Please see, customer, customer is equal to new local customer. Now when I say customer dot, I say create invoice, it will print me the line that was specific to, I mean the logic that is specific to local customer. But the moment I change this to export customer, and when I execute the same piece of code, you see it actually prints what? Creating invoice for the export. Why? Because the instance in memory is of type export customer. But what is the reference variable of type? It is of type customer. This principle is known as, okay, clients being dependent on abstraction and not on implementation, right? We are going to take this further ahead tomorrow in detail. This is a very, very important topic and a very, very specific topic. And here you will end up learning a design pattern called factory pattern. Come on, repeat. What is the design pattern that you will learn eventually? Factory pattern is the design pattern that you will end up learning, and it's going to be fun. I will be talking a lot about inheritance still further tomorrow in the morning, but this was just simply setting the stage for you so that we can do fantastic job tomorrow morning. And what I want you all to do is that whatever I have done, I want you to do the same thing on your own machines, right? We are going to wind up at 6 o'clock, but until that time you still have 8-10 minutes. You can work on this and you can continue. Maybe you can take a break and then once again go back to your cloud labs and then you can start working on it and you can do this. But you must finish this, right, friends? So you must be crystal clear with whatever we have done up till now before we get started with anything else tomorrow in the morning. Right, friends? Yes. Right, this is upcasting. You are right. Okay, so this is how it is. Come on, friends, get started. Come on, get started. So how was, okay, let me first take the feedback. You want me to go slow? You want me to go fast? Do you have any suggestion so that we can, you know, adhere, or we can look into your suggestions right away, before we proceed further tomorrow in the morning? But if you have any feedback, you can absolutely feel free. We are all professionals and we take feedback very, very positively, and we really work and strive to do the best, you know, justify the time and money that is being spent. So any feedback? Do you have any suggestions? Are we going okay, good? You want me to go fast on the topics? You want me to go slow on the topics? Or we are just good? Yeah, I will explain abstraction in detail tomorrow, Anikendu. Yes, I will explain, don't worry. So for now, just, you know, put the code. Just write the code and just play with it. Try your hands, dirty your hands with it. I will explain. Once again, we are going to pick it up tomorrow in the morning. What about others? Hey, come on guys, no feedback, or else at least say, okay, we are good, we are going good, you know, we can proceed further with the same pace. Okay, good, Anand, very nice. Okay, thanks, Monisha, thank you. Sure, thank you. Good. Thank you, Navya, thank you. Thank you. Nice. Okay, then please continue with this. 6 o'clock, we are going to wind up, so we still have, you know, 5 minutes, but otherwise we are good. I think we're good. Thank you, Rakesh. Thank you so much. Thanks. At any given point of time, any time during the course of the training, if you have any suggestions, if you want to give one-to-one, no problem at all. Yes. Thank you, Bhartiya. Thank you so much. Right. Okay. So we are calling it a day, friends. Once again, take a look. We have just, worked with, customer class abstract. I mean, I want you to dirty your hands with this. No problem. It's okay if you have not understood fully. I'm going to revisit this topic tomorrow in the morning. So customer, an abstract class, an abstract method, abstract class, abstract method. Just remember this. And then in the subclasses, you need to implement those abstract methods. You see this? You need to implement those abstract methods. That's it. And the sales app, create a reference variable of superclass, but instantiate it to subclass. That's it. Done. Right? Okay, friends. So see you all tomorrow morning, 9:30. Thank you so much for your participation. It was great. It was great discussing things with you all on day one. Thank you so much. Topics that we will be covered tomorrow so that we can have an overview. No problem, Ashish, you don't need it. Just whatever I keep on sharing with you, just keep on doing those things. Today in the evening, just dirty your hands with your abstract. Spend 10-15 minutes, half an hour max to max, just close down. And watch TV, movies, just whatever you want to do. Tomorrow in the morning, start afresh. Don't